New York is certainly known for its theaters. It is the fourth highest state for having the most of them. In Schenectady, New York, you can find Proctor's Theater. With one of the largest movie screens in the Northeast, it has hosted many famous artists like George Burns, Britney Spears, Mariah Carey even recorded her Thanksgiving special here in 1993. So for anyone familiar with the area, I can almost guarantee you've heard of this Proctor's Theater. But there's one more here that not as many people know about. Behind me here is the abandoned Proctor's Theater that was built in 1914. The architect on this building is amazing, but I think it kind of goes unnoticed because it's kind of just hidden in plain sight. It cost $325,000 to build it originally and seated over 2,000 people. It was the biggest theater in the area at the time. Many A-list Hollywood entertainers performed here. Jack Benny, Jimmy Devante, Bob Hope were just a few of the many. Over time, theater entertainment became less popular and the building needed more repairs. In 1977, The Longest Yard, starring Burt Reynolds, was the last film to ever play here. And the building has been sitting here almost completely untouched ever since. Let's explore. We're heading in. Got my hard hat. Let's see what this place has to offer. I was told to lock the door behind me, so. We're in. We're gonna check this place out. I got Jonah here.
Can you remember it?
Josh.
Jack. Close enough.
What's your name? As always. Yeah.
We're in here right now. This is kind of just the entryway. You got the little refreshment stand over here.
Anybody want a drink?
We got a classic Pepsi sign over there, which is a little ice cream. Anyone want some ice cream? Oh, it's a vending machine?
Yeah. Soda shop. Giant size cold drinks.
With crushed ice.
You got any change on you? Any quarters?
Coming through our first doorway, and this leads us, turn my light on, it's a little dark in here. So this is the first hallway that we reached. A couple different options. Main stage is over here to my left. We got a downstairs over here to my right. The colors in here, just the arch ceilings, it's all just so cool.
What's up?
The paint color is interesting. I don't know if I would have selected this color, but I think nature is having its way and doing the right thing. Apparently there's murals behind all of these paint chips.
There's actually a mural underneath it.
Sure. Actually, I think there's one over here. Check it out.
That's pretty cool. We're gonna head downstairs and then make our way up.
Is that good?
Creepy basement, that's what's down here.
Now we found the bathroom, and this is funny because usually any abandoned spots that we explore, every toilet, every sink is always smashed. This is like the one spot that is not. Found the bathrooms though. Pretty simple, nothing too fancy. This is something they always did in like older architect, and I don't understand. They always have ground urinals. Like the urinals always touch the ground. I don't know why.
Hey, a little privacy, come on.
Who's that?
I wonder if that went upstairs so that like the whole bottom was out, so they probably.
Pyro bar. Bill was here in 1947. 47. Hey, Jerry. Ken. Chucky.
So we made our way back upstairs. Downstairs seemed to be bathrooms, maybe little event spaces. There's like a little fireplace by the bathroom, so I think it's just like a little hangout spot. We're back up here in the main hall now. We're gonna see what else we can find. Okay, well, I just found this little side room and all the original Proctor's lettering is in here. This is really cool. Looks like they're all like neon lettering signs at one point. It looks like there's some new ones in the back. They're still wrapped up. I always love just metal signage.
Maybe bulbs, yeah.
Got the classic movie theater carpet in here. Look at this. Found an old film reel and a bunch of old projector equipment too. Look at this stuff. Much of this theater is long, winding hallways with minimal light. We did our best to explore every doorway, capture everything interesting, and leave out all the empty dark rooms. As we made our way up to the top floor, we found the staircase and it led us to... So this is the projector room here, which is so cool.
So...
And we got the little boxes here with the projector shining through. Looking down into there, this stage was just, it's so steep. It's probably a good 100 feet down there. I know you. How you doing down there?
I'm here for the matinee. When's the show start? It's been 43 years.
Wait, what is the two little dudes from the Muppets?
Is he a bouncing baby boy?
I don't know, but we're high enough up to find out.
I'm up here in the balcony seats right now. The stairs are like so steep. This is crazy. But behind me here, whoa, there's main stage. It's a long way down. This is cool up here, but I want to get down there, check it out.
We have to be careful in here because, as you can see, so much of the plaster molding has just fallen off over the years. And we're not sure when more could just come crashing down from 100 feet up in the air. But the detail that is here is just amazing to look at.
I found the balcony seats. Look at this.
You probably pay more things on you.
Oh yeah.
When's the show start? The stage is gone pretty much.
As we made our way down to stage level, we found a little doorway that led backstage and deeper into the basement. We didn't find much down here. Boiler room, break rooms, maybe elevators, and everything else you'd expect to find in a basement.
There's not much left of the stage here, but I'm standing at the base of it now. It looks like a little staircase back there that used to be able to get under it, I'm assuming. But we got three levels.
So this place officially closed in 1977, and the last film that was ever shown here was...
I totally forgot it.
The Longest Yard by Burt Reynolds. And it said that actually only like less than 40 people showed up that day to come see it. This place is sat here untouched. Our goal here, I want to bring this theater back to life. Did you bring popcorn?
I did not.
Oh, there's some right there.
Oh, nice.
What movie are we watching?
Burt Reynolds, The Longest Yard.
How many times have I asked you that question?
Too many. So apparently less than 40 people showed up to the last screening?
Yeah, so there's even less this time.
Yeah.
Like a black cat do. Give me the police.
We brought the theater back to life with the EcoFlow Pro Max 2. It's a portable power station. Bring it anywhere you want. Portable power, wherever you go. Thank you for sponsoring this episode.
What movie have we seen again?
Burt Reynolds, The Last Yard.
Oh.
Longest Yard.
Thank you. Come on. Close it down.